I have a few notes here because I have 2 minutes. I hope Bill gives me maybe an extra minute or so. But I want to give up a huge presente for a man who was my friend, who was a true revolutionary at heart, who was the real deal. And they thought with him in the grave that the Bolivarian Revolution would end, but it has not, and we're here. As proof of that, I want to give us a presente for President Hugo Chavez. Presente. On behalf of the Global Women's Strike and women of color in the Global Women's Strike, I'm here with you today to say no to U.S. intervention, militarily or otherwise, in Venezuela, and to oppose the lying corporate reporting on Venezuela. I'm also here, standing here, to say no to U.S. policies and intervention in Haiti. And I'll tell you why I'm doing that. I have a really hard time talking about Venezuela and what's going on in Venezuela without talking about Haiti. The history of both Venezuela and Haiti are intertwined. Today, as we watch the slow motion U.S. orchestrated attempted coup in Venezuela limp along, we also see in Haiti the U.S. prop up a brutal regime that they installed in that island nation, and they are complicit in the massacres and tortures going on in Haiti that get no reporting in the corporate or even the alternative media in the United States and around the world. There are massacres that took place yesterday. There are massacres that are taking place today. There's a reason that you're not seeing anything about Haiti in the corporate media, but you're hearing all kinds nearly every day. You hear the propaganda about Venezuela. Because when the United States is interested in regime change, that's what they do. They're propping up a brutal, corrupt regime in Haiti, so they're not gonna talk about that. They're not gonna talk about all the lives that are lost in Haiti, but they're gonna spread lies about what's going on in Venezuela. You know, when the late Hugo Chavez visited Haiti after a U.S.-backed coup toppled the first democratically elected president, Jean-Bertrand Aristide, the Haitian grassroots greeted President Chavez in the tens of thousands. He actually left the presidential palace and went down to the gate to greet the people. And the people said to Hugo Chavez, "You are our president until the return of President Aristide." The Haitian grassroots loved Hugo Chavez for a number of things, for his practical solidarity, but also for his anti-racist stand by declaring his pride in his African roots. Rare in the region that a leader would do that. And women in Haiti and around the world who live the impact of poverty and the lack of valuation of their work, they understand the significance of Article 88 of the Venezuelan Constitution brought in by the Bolivarian Revolution that recognizes the work of mothers and other caregivers and ensures resources for those doing this work with the least. Those of us, like myself, who spent time in Venezuela, we witnessed that women are the beating heart of the Bolivarian Revolution, and President Chavez also often said that from the platform. And in Haiti, they're also the beating heart of the uprising going on there. Women are the beating heart of the ongoing uprisings against U.S. imperialism in Venezuela as well as Haiti. You know, after the Haitian Revolution, I'll take you back a little bit, the first black republic in the world was established. That was way back in 1804. And after that, Haiti gave Bolivar, the liberator of Latin America, refuge on two occasions. He not only gave Bolivar refuge, but he gave weapons. They also sent fighters and they sent ships. And today, in Venezuela, you could stand on the ground where Haitians died. The Bolivarian Revolution recognizes that. We all owe a great debt to Haiti from Venezuela, but for all of us in the Americas. So at the same time that we're standing to say hands off to the U.S., hands off Venezuela, I really encourage you to find out the truth of what's going on in Haiti and also stand with the Haitians. Haitian grassroots who have been victims of vicious racism for so long. You know, the Haitians asked Bolivar one thing. They said, when you go back, you stand against slavery. And the first U.S., the first America's conference that happened, that Bolivar participated in, Haiti was invited, and the United States said, we're not going to sit at the table with niggas. And Bolivar didn't get through. But he never forgot that, and Hugo Chavez never forgot that, and we must never forget that. Okay, so we have to wrap our heads around this. We have to wrap our heads around the fact that the United States, yes, they're after oil in Venezuela, but it's not only the oil. They cannot, they're also going after Cuba. You might notice Bolton, when they talk about Venezuela, they talk about Maduro, they also talk about getting the Cubans out of Venezuela. And we know what the Cubans are doing in Venezuela. We've seen them there. They're the doctors. They're training teachers. That's what they do throughout the Caribbean region and throughout the world. 94% of the Cubans in Venezuela, that is what they're doing. So at the same time they're spreading the propaganda that Haitians can't get medical care, they want to kick out of Venezuela in the barrios from those sloping hillsides, the Cuban doctors who are there servicing the people. But we also know that part of what the U.S. is about, they want the oil, okay? They want to go after Cuba, but they also want to make sure that there is no socialist experiment that happens anywhere in the Americas and in the world that can succeed. And that's also why they went after President Jean-Bertrand Aristide in Haiti. A lot of people don't know that. Finally, I just want to say that as we stand in solidarity with the Venezuelan Bolivarian strugglers, we have to also stand in solidarity with the people of Haiti, as I've said. Haitians today are on the streets, not like the racist Guaido-led throng backed by the U.S. in Venezuela. Pretty white. Have you seen the photos? Yeah. Romero Funes, by the way, who's here, he's the assistant producer of Sojourner Truth. You hear his name on the show. Let's give it up for Romero, young Honduran man with Garifuna roots, and he's just terrific. And he dug up this photo and showed it to me, where he showed Guaido's, you know, operation, which was mainly 99.9.5% white, all right, and the Maduro supporters that were very mixed racially. But just as Venezuelans are trying to complete and secure their Bolivarian revolution, Haitians are also trying to complete the revolution they began way before 1804. And they, like the Bolivarian strugglers, are determined to continue to struggle until they win. And whether or not we here in the United States win our freedom depends on the victories of the peoples of movements in Venezuela and around the world, from the continents of Africa to Asia to Haiti to the Caribbean to Palestine. We will not win if they don't win. We need to wrap our minds around that. Now, the Haitians say, we will not obey. They have a slogan that says, we will not obey. And today we say, we will not obey this brutal Trump regime and all of their 1% friends. We refuse to remain silent. Long live the people's movements in Venezuela and everywhere from Africa to Haiti. U.S. out of Venezuela. U.S. hands off Venezuela. U.S. hands off Haiti. Thank you very much.